Every Night is Pizza Night, written by J. Kenji Lopez Alt, illustrated by Gianna Ruggiero. Tonight is pizza night, so was last night. We're making pizza tomorrow too. Actually, every night is pizza night, because pizza is the best. This is a scientific fact. I have done the test to prove it. Test number 4, waffle iron. Messy, worth it. Test number 18, the cold morning slice. Test number 22, pizza math. The Pythagorean theorem, triangles taste better. Test number 37, pizza in the dark. Hello pizza, my old friend. Test number 86, pizza upside down. Yum. Test number 91, pizza upside down. Yum. Mr. Gonzalez knows my shopping list by heart. Everyone in the neighborhood shops at his store. Plain cheese can't be topped, Pipo, but how about some pepperoni this time? I admit, not everyone wants pizza all the time. I long for a grapefruit. Exhibit A, my papa. Mama says, think of what you're missing. There's chicken pot pie, chicken knot pie, 5 bean chili, don't be silly, Peking duck, Peking yuck, French onion soup, French onion okay, but how do you know pizza is best if you never try anything else? What if mama's right? My science teacher, Ms. Buffon, says a good scientist always wants more data. Data? Says Papa. You have the whole neighborhood. All right. I'll do it. I do not need to. I do not want to. But I will try other foods. I will do it for science. My neighbor Eugene thinks the best food is bibimbap. That's bibimbap. He's wrong. This is our old family recipe, he says. My pizza is not an old family recipe. Papa found it on a bag of flour. The colors in the old stone bowl are so pretty. I can't blink, even though I know I'm supposed to. It smells spicy. It smells stinky. It does not smell like pizza. I do not need it. I do not want it. I will try it for science. Yeah! It is spicy! And I love it. Crunchy carrots, cool cucumbers, and rice. You're so delicious. And there's so many of you. Bibimbap, you are a taste sensation. If being stinky is wrong, I don't want to be right. This is new. This is exciting. Is this better than pizza? Thank you and excuse me, but I need more data. I stop at the end of the hall where Farah lives. She says the best food is tagine. That's tagine. You make it by cooking a bit of this and a little of that under a clay hat. When I smell tagine cooking, it reminds me of my old home, she says. When I smell pizza cooking, it reminds me how much I love pizza. At the markets, you can get just the right spices for chicken, chickpeas, or even camel, she says. Do camels like pizza? Probably yes. The tagine is ready, so Farah lifts up the lid. Chicken is okay, and so are apricots. But together? Wild. I do not need it. I do not want it, but I will try it. I try another bite, then another, just to be sure. I can't stop. I'm a tagine machine. Chicken and apricots, you do belong together. Together forever in my belly. And spices? Show me the flavors. Is this better than pizza? Thank you, Farah, but I need more data. Dakota lives down the street. She's got a big pot on her stove, big enough for Mutsy to take a bath in. This is my mama's red bean and rice. It's the best way to make someone feel good. Maybe even better than a hug, she tells me. So when Papa gets sad, I cook up a big old pot for him. Does it always work? I ask. It never hurts, Dakota tells me. The beans look like big shiny beetles swimming in mud. At least I know rice is nice. I do not need it. I do not want it, but I will try it. Once you've had bibimbap and tagine, nothing can surprise. Holy pepperoni, this is good! Garlicky garlic, peppery peppers, celery cellars. It's like a great big hug around my belly. Is this better than pizza? I still need more data. Ronnie and Donnie run the dumpling truck down the street. They say dumplings are the best. "First, Donnie shared his dumplings with just me," Ronnie said.
"Then we shared them with all our friends," says Donnie. "And now we share them with the whole neighborhood."
They look good. They look warm and cozy. But the best? I kinda need to try them. Just for science, of course.
"Careful, Pipo, they're really juicy."
"Back off, Donnie, I'm a scientist." "Ah, dumplings. Your middles are so hot and juicy. Your skins are so thin and stretchy. Little purses of delight. Are you better than pizza?"
"Data, Donnie, data."
I pull out my emergency pizza slice and take a bite. Then another dumpling. Then more pizza. Then another dumpling. Dumplings are good, but pizza is still the best. It is scientific fact. So, how can so many happy people be so wrong? I will ask Mr. Gonzalez. He knows everyone. He's tried everything. He will know what the best food is. "Mr. Gonzalez, Mr. Gonzalez," I shout.
"What is it, Pipo?"
"I have to know. Is pizza the best food in the world?"
"Of course it is."
He agrees. I knew it. I knew it all along. "Of course pizza is the best."
"Pipo, pizza is the best, but it's not the only best."
"Huh?"
"When it's cold out, the best is matzo ball soup from Levi's. When I want an extra rich treat, it's Vincenzo's chocolate cake. Famous Fred's Famous Franks are the best when I'm in a rush. Or maybe that's Mrs. Mendoza's empanadas. Sometimes I just want hot buttered popcorn and nothing else will do. And of course my mother's spicy green pozole soup is always the best." I say thank you and walk home. Is Mr. Gonzalez right? How can so many things be the best? How can science explain that? Pizza always tastes good. Does that make it the best? Is the best food a family recipe? Is it something that reminds you of home? Is the best food the kind that says "I love you" without making a sound? Or is it just something you like to share? I've got to perform an experiment. Time to get baking. Test number 99. Pizza party! Tagine party at my house next week. Pipo, your pizza is the best.
Best pizza ever.
The science is in. According to my new data, pizza really is the best. But I'm pretty sure there are still a lot more bests I can try. Papa asks, "What's for dinner tomorrow, Pipo?" "How about green pozole soup? I hear it's the best." Pipo's pizza. Pipo's pan pizza is perfect for help from little hands. It's a flexible recipe that can be made either from scratch or with store-bought fresh pizza dough. It's delicious either way. Very young children can help by dumping the pre-measured ingredients into a big bowl for the dough, as well as with adding sauce and cheese, so long as you don't mind some of the cheese disappearing on the way to the pizza. Older kids can help scoop flour with measuring cups or operate the kitchen scale, depending on whether you prefer cups or grams. Incidentally, measuring in grams using a kitchen scale is the most consistent way to make dough. Every kid loves to knead. The pizza bakes at a high temperature and the pan will be screaming hot when it comes out of the oven, so be careful if the cubs until everything cools down. Pipo likes her pizza plain, but you can add as many toppings as you'd like. This particular pizza recipe is hearty enough to take on a big old pile of toppings without collapsing or flopping. P.S. Make sure you don't wear your nicest clothes while cooking. Tomato sauce has a way of jumping out at you unexpectedly. Ingredients for Pipo's pizza. This recipe makes two 10-inch thick crust pizza. Plenty for two adults, a couple children, and maybe a dog. For homemade dough, 2.5 cups, 350 grams, flour, plus more for dusting, 1.5 teaspoons, 8 grams, table salt, 2 teaspoons, 8 grams, instant or rapid rise yeast, 1 cup water, 2 teaspoons, 8 grams, olive oil, plus a few tablespoons more for the pans and for drizzling. For store-bought dough, 1 pound of store-bought pizza dough, thawed in the fridge overnight if it starts out frozen. For toppings, 1.5 cups of your favorite pizza sauce. Good quality crushed tomatoes seasoned with just a little salt makes an excellent sauce. 12 ounces of grated low moisture mozzarella cheese. Any toppings you'd like. Pipo tops hers with fresh basil and Parmesan cheese. Her mama prefers Hawaiian.
Papa is just along for the ride. And before you start, remember, even imperfect pizza is still pizza, and pizza is always delicious.
For the dough, mix the flour, salt, and yeast in a big bowl with your hands or a wooden spoon. Add the water and olive oil and keep on mixing until the dough comes together into a ball. Dump the dough out into a lightly floured countertop, then knead it with your hands until it is smooth and elastic. The dough should feel pretty wet. If you're using store-bought dough, start here. Divide the dough into two halves. With lightly floured hands, gather each half into a ball, holding it up off the counter. Pour a few tablespoons of olive oil into the bottoms of two 10-inch round cake pans or cast iron pans, and rub it all around with your hands to coat the bottom and sides. Don't wash your hands yet. Plop a dough ball into the center of each pan and turn it over a few times to coat it in olive oil. Cover the pans with plastic wrap and set them aside in a warm place for about 2 hours. Go read a book or play a really long round of hide and seek. To top and bake, set the oven rack to the lowest shelf and then preheat the oven as hot as it will go, 500 degrees to 550 degrees Fahrenheit. Remove the plastic wrap, then push, pull, and stretch the dough out into the corners of the pans, completely filling them and making sure no big air bubbles are trapped underneath. It's okay if you accidentally poke a few holes. Pizza is always delicious. Cover each pizza with sauce, grated mozzarella, and whatever toppings you'd like. Bake until the tops of the pizza are bubbly and the bottoms, when you carefully lift the edges with a thin spatula, are golden brown and crisp. Be very careful with small hands here because the pans are hot. This will take around 12 to 15 minutes, depending on your oven. You can finish the pizza on the stovetop for an extra crispy crust. Transfer the pizzas to a cutting board, slice, and eat. Make sure to invite your friends.